what's catching me unless I wanna be caught. I'm dancing in the shadows, ain't no leash when I walk. It's great to feel invincible, it's great to feel alive. My appetite's insatiable, there's nowhere it can hide. Our freedom isn't up to them, it's only up to us. I'm the alpha, I'm the leader.
It's a girl, T.I.E here, which stands for Together Individual Entertainment. And as you can tell, I'm indoors today. The reason I'm indoors is because it's raining, it's cold. Normally, I want to do my read-alongs outside, but in this case, I got to make an exception for those bad weather days. So today, I'm doing my read-alongs indoors where it's nice and warm and it's dry, because if I went outside in that rain with the book, it would just be soggy and everything, so I didn't want that. We're still in the scary Disney Halloween stories, and today's story is Shadows in the Jungle, and that is basically a Jungle Book story. So we're gonna get started with Shadows in the Jungle. Here we go. It was a sunny afternoon in the jungle. The Dawn Patrol was on its afternoon march. Colonia and Hathi marched at the front of the line. His son brought up the rear. Hop, two, three, four, the elephants chanted as the patrol marched through a row of flowery trees. Colonel Hathi's trunk began to twitch. Then it wiggled. Then, achoo! The colonel sneezed and was jerking backward. He bumped into the elephant behind him. The elephant bumped into the next elephant, and that elephant into the one behind him. The elephants kept bumping into each other until, bam! The next elephant bumped into Hathi's son. The little elephant tumbled backwards into a large hole in the ground. Thump! The baby elephant landed in a heap. He blinked his eyelids and looked around. He was in a cave. Spiders and strange bugs skittered up the walls and across the floor in front of him. The wind whipped eerily through several dark tunnels. The elephant didn't know which way to go. He couldn't be sure any of the tunnels would lead him out of the cave. And they all looked so scary. Help! He cried. The elephant's voice echoed throughout the cave, but the Dawn Patrol had already marched on. They didn't hear the elephant's call for help. Across the jungle, Shere Khan's ears twitched. The sound like the cry of a helpless animal. The tiger purred in his deep voice. Music to my ears. Shere Khan swiftly made his way toward the sound, his paddled feet moving silently across the jungle floor. Hanging in the nearby trees, three monkeys heard the elephant's call for help, too. What's that? The first monkey asked. Let's go see, the second monkey said. The monkey swung from branch to branch, heading toward the noise. But they stopped until they saw Shere Khan. Never mind, the third monkey whispered nervously. Let's get out of here. On the ground below, Mowgli and Baloo were having fun rolling down a hill. Hey, Mowgli called out as the monkey swung past them. What's the hurry? The monkey stopped. We didn't hear anything, the first monkey shouted. We didn't see anything either, the second monkey yelled. That's right, said the third monkey. We definitely did not hear a little elephant call out for help or see Shere Khan making his way toward the sound. Mowgli jumped up. A little elephant? Hathi's son is in trouble. Which way did you not hear a little elephant call for help? Baloo asked. The monkeys all pointed over their shoulder, and Baloo and Mowgli ran off to help their friend. Meanwhile, back in the cave, the light was beginning to fade. The poor baby elephant stared at the tunnels. Pop will come for me, he told himself, settling down to wait. I'm sure the Dawn Patrol will be here any minute to rescue me. The little elephant shivered. A strange feeling had come over him, a feeling that he wasn't alone in the cave anymore. Hello? He called out, his voice shaking. Is someone there? Suddenly, two large yellow eyes appeared in one of the dark tunnels. The little elephant froze with fear as Shere Khan stepped out of the darkness. Good afternoon, the tiger said, his eyes fixed intently on the elephant. Mowgli and Baloo heard the elephant cry. They raced toward the sound as fast as they could. They soon came to a cave in the side of a rocky cliff. He must be in there, Mowgli said, starting forward and Baloo stopped him. "Look there, little buddy," the bear said. He pointed to some fresh paw prints leading to the cave. "Tiger paw prints!" "We gotta do something," Moaning said. Determined to help his friend, he looked at the cave. He saw the last rays of the setting sun starting to fade. Mowgli said, scratching his chin. "I've got an idea, but I'll need your help." Inside the cave, Shere Khan grinned silently at the elephant. "Your father and his elephant patrol are quite fierce," the tiger murmured in his deep, smooth voice. "But you, little one, are another story. You shall make quite a tasty morsel." The baby elephant gulped. What would his pops do now? "You won't eat me," he said, trying to look as brave as he could. "The dawn patrol will rescue me." Shere Khan shook his head. "They're long gone," he said, "and even if they were here, they do not scare me. Now let us finish this." The tiger moved forward, but then stopped. Shadows had started to flicker on the wall. The little elephant saw Shere Khan's scared face and turned around to look. "Men!" the elephant cried. "Men with torches!" Nothing frightened Shere Khan more than man and his fire. The tiger growled. "Our dinner engagement will have to wait, I'm afraid," he said. And with that, he raced out of the cave. Hidden from sight, Mowgli and Baloo watched the frightened tiger and sprint into the jungle. When they were sure Shere Khan was gone, Mowgli and Baloo stepped into the cave. "Are you all right?" Mowgli asked. "Is that you, Mowgli?" the elephant called. "I'm fine, but how did you find me?" "We followed the sound of your cry to the cave," Mowgli said. "This tunnel led us right to you." Mowgli ran to his friend and hugged him. "Don't you worry about Shere Khan," he said. "We got rid of him." "But where are the men and their torches?" the elephant asked. Baloo held up some of the leaves. "Just a little trick in the light." The three friends set off through the tunnel and back into the jungle. They came out of the cave just in time to see the dawn patrol marching toward them. "Pop!" the little elephant cried, running up to his father. "I fell into a cave and Shere Khan almost got me, but Mowgli and Baloo saved me," the little elephant cried. "Thank you both," Colonel Happy said, "and I am in your debt," Mowgli grinned. "That's what friends are for." All right, so I hope you enjoyed Shadows in the Jungle. The next one will be a Finding Nemo story, The Ghost Light Fish. I really cannot wait to get started on that story because, in a way, I do remember a fish who does light up in the ocean. They call it an anglerfish, but that's way deep in the ocean of darkness. But still, I hope you enjoyed this little Halloween story, Disney, once again. And I cannot wait to continue until the day after Halloween.